When we talk about the largest supercomputers in the world, we think about Google, Amazon, or Tesla. But one Chinese company is breaking all the records. Alibaba's Zhebing Computing Center is the largest scale of AI computation ever built. This entire place can together compute 12 quintillion floating point operations per second. In other words, 2.5 million iPhone 14s put together. This is 30% more powerful than the largest made by Google in its Oklahoma facility, and 500% more powerful than Tesla's used for training self-driving cars. Alibaba Cloud also broke another record in searching an image out of 50,000 images in less than half the previous record time and at the lowest cost. The recent submissions are even more promising to Chinese cloud providers, with the top hardware from Alibaba taking less than 0.08 milliseconds. Such incredible performance translates into increased research for China's AI ambitions, like self-driving cars, drones, medical science, and a whole suite of deep learning applications, including the national military, but only if the US allows. Well, the catch is that none of these achievements would be possible without the powerful GPUs by Nvidia, specifically the premium tier chips like A100 and the recently released H100. And not surprisingly, these chips are the first in the US government's Chinese blacklist, and hence the epicenter of all the politics. From the US Senate on export controls over the chips, to the Chinese industries on the dependency on the US semiconductor technology. So, what's so special about Nvidia's A100 and H100 chips? Why does China need these chips? How do these affect the Chinese ambitions? What's the real reason behind the US restrictions on these chips to China? And how badly does it affect the Chinese industries? So, what's special about Nvidia's A100 and H100 chips, or GPUs in general? The answer to this lies in the digital economy of the 21st century. Cloud computing has been the backbone of this digital era, with the market size growing exponentially every year. Most cloud workloads today involves AI, with over 80% of the US companies set to accelerate AI adoption over the past 2 years. And the same 2 years ago, most cloud providers had Nvidia's V100 as the top AI offerings. These chips were great for applications with numeric calculations and best suited for machine learning. Then, Nvidia announced A100 GPUs based on its Ampere architecture that claimed to provide performance improvements up to 40% in floating point 64 type calculations. Naturally, these numbers were the big boost to the modern and complex AI training systems, like Microsoft's NLG, a 17 billion parameter language model, having great performance gains. The new H100 chips takes the performance leap further in the same direction. But how do these numbers fit in the Chinese equation? Well, Chinese universities' leading AI research publications almost double the US. Most of the AI research involves machine learning, deep learning, or natural language processing that Nvidia's chips are optimized for. Noticeably, the Zhejiang University, the Harbin Institute of Technology, and the NORTHWESTERN POLYTECHNICAL University are each reported to have around 2,000 AI research publications. This, coupled with the increasing trend of the Chinese AI citations and a decreasing trend of the US, clearly shows the importance of the AI research and hence the computing in China. While all these sound good, here comes the most interesting part. The People's Liberation Army of China, or PLA in short, leads in AI deployments for military applications. As per the estimates, the PLA has invested between $1.6 billion to $2.7 billion US dollars on AI research and deployments per year, which is equivalent to the US military. Most of these AI developments can be categorized into six main areas, starting from autonomous driving vehicles, surveillance and reconnaissance, automatic target recognition, information and electronic warfare, virtual and augmented based training, and command and control. These developments are part of China's ongoing transformation into a mechanized military force with information and network capabilities. A notable example of this is a semi-autonomous drone mothership or AI drone carrier that can launch multiple autonomous UAVs, boats, and small submarines. No doubt, all these ambitions require powerful computation, and Nvidia's AI chips can be the very solution to the puzzle. Well, by now it's super clear that artificial intelligence plays an important role in national and international security. This might well be the reason why the US is keen on banning AI chips to the Chinese. These advanced AI chips need complex supply chains for manufacturing, which are primarily concentrated in the US and a small number of allied democracies. This provides an opportunity for export control policies and hence restrictions on Nvidia's and AMD's top-tier chips. But for China, which almost has a million businesses related to AI, the ban has an immediate effect. Most of the cloud computing infrastructures, research facilities, and smart vehicles depend on Nvidia's chips, including the A100, and there's no immediate substitute. The full extended effect of the ban is hard to evaluate, but we can sense the situation from this. After the possible US AI chip ban, President Xi Jinping stressed at a key meeting that China must increase the development of critical technologies to national security and adopt a top-down new whole country system to seek breakthroughs, hinting the very semiconductor dependencies without mentioning the GPU restrictions by the US. Please subscribe to the channel if you want more videos on strategic geopolitics that matters to everyone, and also please press the like button.